First, there was light, or the light bulb, one of the earliest, widely adopted consumer uses of electricity. The product market fit was clear. Being able to see after dark was a compelling use case. Soon, thanks to power companies like General Electric, electricity for light bulbs was piped directly into homes. By 1910, 10% of Americans had electricity. By 1930, that number was nearly 75%. So, naturally, innovators started to wonder, since people already have the electricity, what other use cases are there? Too hot or too cold? Try an electric heater or fan. Tired of housework? Use the electric iron or electric toaster. Bored? Turn on the electric radio. But the advent of new electronic devices was held back by a critical limitation. You couldn't really adjust any of these devices. They were simply either on or off. That all changed thanks to yet another invention, the transistor. The transistor used electricity not only to power the device, but to help control it. Transistors, the first and most basic version of the so-called semiconductors, are like tiny switches. Using a small electrical current, you can flip them from one mode to another. With a transistor, a turned-on toaster can now have two different modes, high heat or low heat, for example, depending on which way the transistor is flipped. Soon, transistors evolved into more sophisticated semiconductor chips, combining many more of these tiny switches. Eventually, chips could store and process digital information as zeros and ones. The rest is literal computing history. So here was the big flip. Electrical devices became electronic devices. Devices powered by electricity and controlled by electricity, using chips. Since the 1950s, chips have rapidly advanced, and we've seen more innovative devices geared to more consumer use cases. Today, the landscape of consumer electronics is vast. There are many companies making a wide range of different types of devices. As we'll see, this sector spans everything from smartphones to speakers to cameras and more. The industry includes giants like Apple and Samsung Electronics, who play across many types of devices, as well as a long tail of smaller players who focus more narrowly. This is a fast-moving industry, and keeping up with consumer demand and the latest innovations is no easy feat. Remember the demise of BlackBerry, now seen as a cautionary tale? And while many of us know this sector from the outside, as users of these devices, we may be surprised to learn how it works from an insider's perspective. In this primer, we'll cover the landscape of products and companies, the drivers of value, the various production and sales models, the metrics used, and the key trends to expect.